What's up, guys? It's been a few days since I posted a video. Been kind of busy and the weather hasn't been cooperating like it should. I got my camera on my shoulder mount. See, got both hands free. So I can walk around and I can still interact. Yeah, I mean, it's probably a little bouncy because I ain't holding it. I ain't got my tooth in. I ain't felt like putting it in. There's a bunch of my videos I just ain't felt like putting it in. So let's we're heading out here in the back and see and what we can find. So let's head back here and see what we can find out. All right, we're back here where my last video had cut off. I pulled an old camera out of storage and I was going to use it, and come to find out the reason I quit using it was it doesn't have a good hard drive on it. You can only record about 2 minutes unless you got an SD chip in it. I'm kind of sorry for the bouncy here and walking down a hill. And anyway, I got my other camera. I got me a chip also. I'm not sure how well you can see me with the sun in my back. I'm looking at my screen right there and I can't see crap. So, but it don't matter. It don't matter. Let's see. Let's just walk, you know, back here a little ways. A couple of months ago, when I was out here just looking around trying to find some spots to do some filming in, it's a pretty nice little area out here. Very concluded, yeah. I mean, there's a bunch of tracks with four-wheelers, but there's hardly any that come out through here. You know, we're going to one spot. It might take me a few minutes to get there. But, here's the area that we're in. And we're gonna go to that spot right there. Crap. That's as close to zoom in. It's a pretty nice area. I need to get me another mount for this shoulder mount to extend the camera a little bit further out away from my face. Cause it's kinda right. Right there in on me. I'm not sure. I was just fooling around with the camera here. Trying to remember. Oh well, like I said, I was trying to work with a camera. It didn't work too well. But this is where we're heading and everything. It has a... Shut up. It's... Got a landlord's dog. He's out here following us. But like I was about to say was... It had rained here a couple of nights ago. And it's been cold. And the sun ain't really been out. So the ground's pretty still soft and wet. So maybe we can find something out here. And there's a little creek. So, I mean, there's plenty of water. There's a water source for Bigfoot right here. See? I mean, it goes pretty good ways. And everything. And it goes off into the woods right there. Which, that'll probably be another day. I'll take y'all out there another day. It's nice. I went out there a couple of months ago. I followed it and went up a little hill. It was like an old road. Not a paved road, like a dirt road. Very, very old dirt road. So, you know, maybe one day I'll take y'all out there and we can see, you know, how things look. Now, this camera right here, if it looks like I'm getting crooked and everything, because I'm not holding it. I'm not. It's made to be held when you have the camera on it, as well as on your shoulder. But right now I'm going hands-free with it. This little camera I got, you really don't need to be held. So, I mean, this thing, it comes in handy. So, see how much battery life I got. Yeah, I'm doing pretty good. I think I got like an hour on this chilp, which that's pretty good. So,
oh God.
Well, as you can see, pretty nice little secluded area right here. You know, I've been looking around and I'm not seeing no tracks. So, I don't know. I mean, we're walking the power line. And you can see the distance. From side to side, it's pretty good. I'd say half of a football field wide. Something like that. Yeah. So, we'll walk down here when. Well, no. I don't feel like walking all the way down there. But you can see there's a spot right there that be a great little area. Yeah, we'll walk down there so y'all can see, you know, what I'm talking about. Find a good way to get down here. It's a nice, it's down here, and there's, if it's Bigfoot out here, this'll probably be a good spot for him to call it a night, because he's got something above his head, got something in his back, and can't nothing really, you know, come in on him without him knowing about it. You see what I mean? So there's the top. And then right there. So I mean, he's got water right here also. Because when it rains, or it's been raining for a while, you got water pouring down. I'm not sure if y'all can see this or not, but I'm sure you can hear it. Yeah, there you go. So you got water pouring off the top. Let's go up in here. And like I said, it's a pretty well secluded area. Excuse me. I had a piece of chicken. I had chicken chili. And it's a pretty well secluded area. So please just stand back here. Whoo! Whoo! Echoes pretty well. There's a little Bigfoot right there. Get out of that water. But, and then, it's gorgeous back here. You know, I've been thinking about doing a little survival video. And this will be the area. Good Lord, I got a big old gap in my mouth. But, well, these videos ain't professional anyway. Well, it's something professional, I'll have my tooth in. But this is what it looks like right here. And this is the first time I've been down here with the water actually pouring down. You can only imagine after a heavy rain what it'll look like. It'll be a little waterfall. I mean, we got a little waterfall here now, but oh my God, if a big storm came, you know, so yeah, I got two cameras if you ain't noticed. So we're just, I'm out looking right now at some footprints. I see a spot right there. Looks like a dog. That might be a deer. But I'm the only one that works on these videos right here. You know, my opening scene and ending and the editing, the music. Well, the music I get offline. So, but other than that, all my other editing stuff I do. So let's just, you know, walk around here. Yep. And see what we all got. You see, there's, now, I don't know if this stuff is edible or not. I haven't really looked into actual what can be eaten, what can't be. So, but as you can tell, I mean, there's a lot of green here that he can probably eat. You see, I ain't never took this little road right here, so this is something new for me. But still. Yeah. Oh wow. But the area I'm in, it's in between Beach Grove Road and 13. I'm not going to tell you the exact location. So, you know, maybe this is a little area that the road comes out at, so I never was really taking it. Coming back, coming from my house. It might be. But let's just walk around out here and see what we can find. I'm not worried about being quiet right now, walking out through here. It's a nice warm day. And it's been cold the last couple of nights. Let's see. Last night I think it got down to, I think they forecast 27. We're pretty good ways up here. I mean, the camera here probably won't give you a good example of actually how far up you are. Hold my finger. So, let's just. Look around. We're gonna just kind of sit down right here, and over here, sit down, and just let everything be quiet and just listen. Over here, sit down. And of course, the little dog's gonna be running around. Of course, he's a little pain in the butt. I don't know what kind of dog he is. My landlord got him a couple of months ago. And, thanks for living in our house. From our other videos, if you're saying we've got, you know, a lab and a weenie dog. You know, it's amazing, you know, just sitting here looking around. You know, looking off in the distance. Up this way right here. You know, you can't really tell on the camera here. But just sitting here looking. If Bigfoot was up there, we'd never know it. If he was just sitting there watching us, you know. But we'd never know it. I mean, it's just one of them mind-boggling things. It's like sitting out in the middle of the woods. No, let's fucking describe it like this. If you're a deer hunter and you're up in the tree deer don't know you're there until it's too late. Or if you're up in the tree and the deer wanders out, but the deer sees you and you don't see the deer, it's just one of them things. I mean, and I'm so far back now, away from my house and the roads and everything. I'm hearing humming, but it's off of the power lines. You know, sitting here. Today's a holiday, so of course there ain't a lot of traffic out. Every once in a while you can hear a car off in the distance. But to actually get out in nature, see, that's the other camera I was using. To actually get out here in nature and just sit and listen to the water running and falling off the cliffs and everything. And of course dogs splashing in water and all that. Every once in a while you gotta just, you know, get away from everything and just go out and sit in the woods. You know, just take 5 minutes to go and sit. I mean, it's your mind will start just think. You just start thinking about, you know, the way our ancestors lived and everything. You know, looking around these woods here. Can only imagine how the Indians, how life, I'm not going to say how simple it was back then, but you know, really compared to the life we have nowadays, you know, it's It is a lot easier. Easier meaning worries, I'm guessing, I should say. See, today we've got all kind of worries. Financial worries, family worries, all kind of issues going on. But back when our ancestors were here, when the Indians were here, only thing they had to worry about was survival, living, growing their food, hunting, staying alive. Yeah. I guess I'm getting off the subject here and everything. But, you know, it's just something like that, you know, when you're out here in the woods. Something to think about, people. You know, I guess, you know, thinking about it, I had a good life. My dad's side of the family were kind of, you know, city folks. You know, we lived in the city and everything. And my mom and their side of the family were, you know, they lived out in the country. So, you know, I had I had a pretty good life. I had a piece of the cake from both sides of the record. You know, I can go out and live in the woods, in the country, you know, and have a great time. And then again, I can also go out and just live in the city. Have all the luxuries, you know. But yeah, I'm getting off the subject here, so. Well. Let's get back to civilization, I reckon. If you want. This has been Andy Simmons. If you've been watching Bama Buckster or Bama Bigfooter, I'm Paranormal Hunter. I'll try to get out more often and scour my woods here behind the house. Or probably just get out and walk and kind of just think about the way everything was. So, until next time, this has been Paranormal Hunter, aka Andy Simmons, on the channel Paranormal Productions. See you later.